Hey everyone, this is the Asian Nerd. Today I'm going to refurbish this iPhone 6 Plus, which I got from my friend free of charge as a gift. As you can see, the phone has seen better days. The housing is quite scratched and there are dent marks here and there. And the screen is missing some parts, some got chipped out. So I'm going to refurbish its appearance, but with a little twist. I'm going to give this phone a special new housing, which is an imitation product red black housing for the iPhone 6 Plus model, which I got from Taobao.com. Now this will only change the appearance of the phone, which means the logic board is still the iPhone 6 Plus, which everybody knows. Also, I'm going to replace its battery. I'm going to replace it with the Bezos new battery, which has actually a higher capacity, and also a new LCD. To begin with, I undo the pendulum screws at the bottom of the phone, and I place a suction cup on top of the phone and try to pry open the display with the help of a guitar pick. Just insert and have a little twist, and the screen should come off pretty easily. Once it is opened, remember the first thing you have to do is always to disconnect the battery. If you don't disconnect the battery, if you disconnect the display or other components first, there is a chance that component is going to be fried. So always disconnect the battery first. Once the battery is disconnected, you can then proceed to disconnect the LCD away from the phone. Now beware, you should organize your parts and the screws pretty well because there are a million kinds of screws inside the iPhone. So if you put the wrong thing at the wrong hole, it will come up pretty nasty. Trust me. Once the LCD is free, all you gotta do is to transfer some of the old parts to the new LCD. Now the LCD I got from Taobao.com already has the front-facing camera pre-installed, so all I gotta do is to transfer the fingerprint sensor to the new LCD. Now this part is pretty easy. All you gotta do is to unscrew the screws, remove the bracket that is holding the fingerprint sensor, and then use a pryer to carefully pry off the connector from the display, and the Touch ID should be free to go. Next, you can transfer the fingerprint sensor to the new LCD, reconnect the ribbon cable, and screw the bracket back in. And then I reconnect the display back to the phone to see if the display and the fingerprint sensor is working correctly. Now, since the test was very successful, so I proceed to removing the battery. Now the first adhesive strip, it comes off pretty nicely, pretty perfectly, and I thought to myself, what a lucky day I'm having today. Then I proceed to pull the second one out, and... So what about the third one, you might ask? Yeah, it snapped too. It snapped right in the middle. So, with great vengeance and furious anger, I attempt to pry the battery out with brute force. Now that the battery is out of the way, I can finally put the new battery in and reconnect the display to see if everything is working normally before proceeding to transferring the parts to the new housing. After reconnecting everything back in, as you can see here, everything is working fine and dandy. And now, it is finally the time to transfer all the old parts to the new housing. So starting from this point, basically, you will have to disconnect all the ribbon cables, you will have to disconnect all the antenna cables, and you will have to undo a lot of screws. And remember what I said before, the iPhone has a million kinds of screws inside it. So you have to organize your small stuff, don't let them free flow. The new housing already has a lot of parts pre-installed on it, which saves a lot of trouble for me, which is NE18 neat. And one of the things the new housing didn't come with is the rear camera. So I'll have to transfer the rear camera from the old housing to the new one. Next, I have to transfer this antenna bracket thingy to the new housing. Now beware, the cable, the little antenna cable here is kind of fragile, but if you handle it with care, it shouldn't be a problem. After that, the plastic thingy at the top that is holding the logic board in place has to come off and be moved to the new housing too. Now the NFC antenna has to be unscrewed and transferred to the new housing too, but I lost the footage, so I apologize. However, now the logic board is free, all you have to do is to be careful with the antenna cable at the back, pry that off, and the logic board is finally free. But before the reassembly, there are still some small parts that I have to transfer from the old housing to the new one. It really depends on where you are going to get your parts from, because whatever that is pre-installed on the new housing is going to differ a lot. But anyway, once all the necessary small parts are transferred to the new housing, it is time to put everything back in. Here is a montage of the reassembly process. So after the boring montage and all the frustrations caused by the antenna cables, it is finally done. I put the new battery and the new display back in to see if everything works, and as you can see, the display lights up. The display seems to be working very fine, touch is working very fine, the home button is working very fine, and it is also charging, so I consider this as a success. So I disconnected the battery and the new display again to apply new adhesive to the battery. To finish with this restoration slash conversion process, all you have to do is to screw the display connector bracket and the battery connector bracket back in. Now remember what I said earlier about organizing your small parts and screws well? This is where you will find it come in handy. Anyway, once both brackets are screwed in, all you have to do is to clip the LCD into the housing, starting from the top and then work your way down to the bottom. And all that's left is to put the two pantalop screws back in to the bottom of the iPhone. And after that, you have yourself the refurbished converted iPhone 68 Product Red Limited Edition. All in all, it is only an aesthetic change to the iPhone, and inside it is still an iPhone 6 Plus, and you are not going to get any more Apple support as of 2020. But it still feels like it's one of a kind, and I'm still happy to use it. So what do you think? Leave me a comment below, and I will see you all in the next video.